Turn it up and drive it home. It's James Aramuni on 97.8 Dance FM.
I have got an Academy Award winner with me. Also on Forbes' 30 Under 30 list, you may know her as Lara Croft, but here she is, the woman of the hour, Alicia Vikander. How are you?
Wow, that is probably the most exciting presentation I've had in a long time. Thank you.
I'm just practicing for when I start giving away, Oscars and Grammys and stuff. It's very nice to be speaking to you, Alicia. Congratulations on the movie, Tomb Raider.
Thank you.
So, how did it come about to have you cast as the role of Lara Croft? And how important do you think this moment is in your career?
I got the call about, asking about my interest for the film over 2 years ago. So, I mean, for me, the first reaction, I was like, because I grew up with the game and I saw the Angelina Jolie films. And
right.
I was like, well, haven't that been done? And then the producers and the director and filmmakers, they introduced me to the rebooted version of the game that I had only kind of vaguely read about, which is much more like of an origin story. And I've learned, even though I haven't played video games so much for the last 15 years, I've really realized how much she kind of has morphed and evolved over the years. So I really then felt like as an actor that it was a possibility there to make a new angle and treasure all the kind of traits that she are so loved for, and still make something new and exciting for the audience and fans.
You mentioned something though about Lara Croft as a character kind of morphing over the years and being something different. She's kind of this, she's a woman that young girls look up to, right? So you have girls who see this movie and they say, did knowing that influence the way that you wanted to portray Lara in the film?
In any time when you portray, a famous character or person who have lived in real life, you always have to really, pay attention and make sure that you honor that character and give homage to the reasons why she's had such following and people looking up to her. With a rebooted game, they kind of chose to maybe show a more naturalistic side to this character. It's a coming of age story now of a young person who hasn't taken the easy route. She hasn't used the privileges that she's from. Instead, this is really the story of her trying to find her own destiny and path. For each kind of step that she takes, she matures, and I think we really feel like we will root for her when she's forced to bring this warrior out of her step by step.
I can say it's very, very exciting to see that, and it's definitely something people need to look forward to. Coming back with Alicia Vikander of Tomb Raider in just a moment.
Turn it up and drive it home. It's James Aramuni on 97.8 Dance FM.
I'm sitting down with the woman of the hour, Alicia Vikander of Tomb Raider. Now, Alicia, one more question I wanted to ask you. It's kind of a two-parter. So first, I wanted to know how it was for you shooting the parts that you did in Cape Town. And if you could tell me what you would define as the craziest or most memorable moment that you had during filming.
Okay, first of all, I have a love testament for Cape Town. I think it's probably one of the most beautiful places I've seen on Earth. I mean, I woke up looking out at the ocean every morning, having Table Mountain behind me. So anyone who hasn't been there like me before, really, I really recommend to go there. Favorite action, so many. I mean, we had over 100 days of shoot on this film. We did a huge scene that is actually a bit of a homage to the 2013 game of Lara going down a river and then onto, a waterfall and there's a bomber plane involved. All those things were kind of shot over 8 different locations and set up and probably over 10 days. And
right.
To see that magically come together on screen in the end, that was really cool.
That's a very good point that you bring up, because when you're working on something, whether it be film or art, music, you have this passion while you're doing it, but at the end, when you see it all come together, that's when you sit back and you're like, okay, this is beautiful.
It's interesting because I very rarely see my films I'm in when they're actually done. I've been in the edit seeing, maybe 8 different versions of the film. I still haven't seen with the last sound edit. For me as an actor, it's a year or more, now it's almost 2 since the first discussion. But for me, it's that journey, and then it comes down to a 2-hour film.
Right.
Which to me sometimes seems crazy, but I love the journey of making films.
Yeah, it is pretty insane, but it seems like it's worth it. I mean, I know this, but I think the rest of the world, come March 16th, they'll watch Tomb Raider and they will just be thrilled. I'm so happy for you, Alicia, and we are here at Dance FM. It's an honor, first of all, to speak to you and to see what you're doing, and we wish you the best of luck in everything else to come as well.
You're very sweet. Yeah, well, thank you so much, and thank you for enjoying the film. That's so sweet. Have an amazing day.
Ladies and gentlemen, Alicia Vikander of Tomb Raider. Catch it in cinemas, like I said, March 16th. This is 97.8 Dance FM.
Ladies and gentlemen,
you're turning it all the way up.
Dance floor, wherever you are.